number one, you got to rebound. Five guys have got to hit the glass. Not just one guy in each possession, five guys. So if all five guys are rebounding, you're patient, ball-moving offense, and you're alert defensively. I'm talking about being alert loose balls, being alert if you see a guy that's going after offensive rebound and has been blocked out, go ahead and block him out. You got to be alert, take care of the ball movement on offense.
Demons of Northwestern State clad in, I guess that's purple uniforms, trimmed in white, maybe a little gold around the numbers. UALR in their home uniforms, white trimmed in maroon and black. UALR will be shooting basket to our right. We thank the folks at Bumper to Bumper at AC Delco for sponsoring our starting lineups. It'll be Mosley at 6'7", jumping against Jackson at 6'6". Courtney can get up, and he controls the opening tip into the backcourt. And as DeAndre Williams, who played a lot of minutes the other night, he's coming off a knee surgery. His first practice, I think, was Halloween Eve. Lob pass inside, Javez catches, shoots it high off the glass, no good, got his own rebound.
Michael Javez!
2-0 UALR.
We saw first possession, they want to make sure they get it down in the paint to the big guy.
And it's nice to see UALR going in down there, getting that high percentage shot. There's Davis turning around, lobs it inside to Mosley, first foul of the game. Will go against UALR, as the Trojans had no choice but to foul him, as he was going to get an easy
UALR team. Foul on number 10, DeAndre Williams. First personal foul, first team foul.
The ball handles here, they got to contain him, not allowed to get in the paint.
Northwestern State inbounds it, right side of the bucket. They'll get it into Mosley, and he'll kick it out front to Davis, the guard. Down to the right-hand side to Ellis. They'll lob it into Mosley, trying to take Javez one-on-one. He can't do so. Kicks it out cross-court to Stewart. Stewart puts it on the floor, penetrates, dishes it off, taking it hard to the glass. His Robertson shot is no good, out of bounds. He had a shot at getting his own rebound, Pat, couldn't find a handle.
Yeah, that one would have hurt right there, because talking about in the first minute of the game, giving up another offensive rebound. But again, contain that ball handler.
UALR facing full-court pressure for the first time this afternoon. I think Tulsa pressed them at all the other night. They did pressure maybe one-on-one in the backcourt a little bit. Chuck Guy with the basketball. He'll go left side. Sutherland, top of the circle. It comes to Jackson. Courtney squares up, looks inside, nothing doing. Now go right side to DeAndre Williams. DeAndre, I like him as a scorer, Pat, and he's going to have to pick it up a little bit for UALR. He went 1 of 9 the other night. Chuck Guy from long range.
Three-point basket, Chuck Guy. Here comes another three-point T-shirt from Arrow Coach Lines.
Chuck Guy with his first three of the afternoon. 5-0 UALR. Basket by Javez a little bit earlier. Demons working along the right baseline in the corner. And Courtney Jackson reached in behind, slapped it away, and at last was touched by a Northwestern State player.
Great alertness on there. I just worry that Courtney tried to overextend himself there. Chucky Guy had him contained, so don't get out of the position on defense if you don't have to.
Inbounds, it comes to Williams, and everybody else drops down the floor with the exception of Davis, who will guard Williams. DeAndre will favor left side of the floor, far side in front of the scorer's table, takes it down in front of the Northwestern State bench to Jackson. Left baseline, spin move by Courtney, takes it hard to the rack, can't finish it off, couldn't get it over the rim, whistle, and a foul as they battle for the rebound. Let's say
Northwestern State foul on number 42, William Mosley. First personal foul, first team foul. At the line shooting two, Courtney Jackson.
Possession, you have two attempted layups, made one, actually I think made two, missed two, made one, and then you have an open jump shot. So those are all high percentage shots that you get.
Courtney Jackson is not noted as being a good free throw shooter, and he missed that one. These two teams will play again in Nacogdoches. That will be the 29th of November. Courtney makes one out of two, and it's a 6-0 UALR lead. 18-10 to go here in the opening half. A small crowd here on this beautiful Sunday afternoon. A lot of competition with the entertainment dollar with Dallas Cowboys playing the noon game this afternoon. That hurts. Out front from long range, Ellis for three, no good. Offensive rebound, Robertson. Turnaround jumper is up, no good. They battle for the rebound. Javez with those long arms hauls it in. Steve Shields telling his team, push it down the floor, guys. And here comes DeAndre Williams with it. Right side it goes to Sutherland. Tamar. Looking inside, nothing doing. Javez is camped out in the lane. He's been in there about 8 seconds, and they didn't pick up on that. Jackson has it out front to Williams. Splits a couple of defenders, dribbles it off a foot. Courtney Jackson goes on the floor. Jump basketball, and UALR calls.
Timeout on the floor, UALR.
Second timeout here, Pat Bradley. And they look good here in the early going.
Yeah, they do. And you talk about Javez being picked up. One of the things you tell them to do, as a big
comes to Sutherland. Tremar can take it off the dribble. He'll get it to Chuck Guy, though, on the left wing. Chuck can motor from there. He has his pass deflected right into the hands of Jackson, though. Courtney with a fake, takes it in the paint, shoots it up there right-handed, and that's a shot just totally out of control and not his shot. Back the other way, Davis with it. He will give it up to Stewart. Stewart, top of the circle to Ellis. Ellis takes it off the dribble, now reverses the dribble. Chuck Guy hounding him pretty good. Slaps it away from behind, loose basketball on the floor. Chuck Guy saves it to DeAndre Williams. Williams wasn't sure where the ball was, but Chuck was, and he saved it. Guy, left side, lets it fly from long range. No good. Battle for the rebound. They got UALR for coming over the back.
Great example, that three-pointer was a wide-open shot. They did a good job in just being alert on defense. You saw down there.
UALR foul on number 44, Michael Chavez. First personal foul, second team foul.
Because against this team with that shot blocker, you got to be able to score in transition as often as possible.
And if there's one guy on this UALR team that does have the green light to shoot that three, it would be Chuck Guy, because he can get on fire in a hurry. Robertson out on the floor. Foot was on the line.
Gary Robertson.
And Northwestern State out of Louisiana gets on the board 6-2 as we hit the 16-and-a-half-minute mark. We'll be back here Tuesday night against IUPUI. Well, that's a mouthful. That's Indiana University, Purdue University, Indianapolis is what all that stands for.
They just couldn't make up their minds, huh?
Game time's at 7:05 whistle as Chavez tries to back his man down, and they will get Mosley for the foul, and that's number two on him.
Northwestern State foul on number 42, William Mosley. Second personal foul, second team foul.
Helps them press. We haven't seen any traps by Northwestern State on the front court.
Checking in the ball game for UALR, number five, Eric Lawton. And for Northwestern State, number 33, James Holbin.
Replaced by Holbin, James Holbin, the 6'8 junior from Shreveport. Mosley's a senior. He did not like that last call at all. The freshman backed him down and call for the foul. Inbounds, it comes to Lawton, who just checked into the game for the first time this afternoon. He replaces Chuck Guy. Out front, it is DeAndre Williams in front of the Baptist Health sign on the far side. He'll take it off the dribble. He can pull up, pop it from there, chooses not to do so. Jackson will let it fly from the right side. Shot is no good. Battle for the rebound. Let's see who this foul is on. And they'll get Chavez, I believe, for coming over the back.
He's being aggressive. I think that's
UALR foul on number 44, Michael Chavez. Second personal foul, third team foul.
Good ball.
We've got a media timeout.
That was a three, which, you know, maybe you could have got us something better there, but it was open.
All right, we got a media timeout. 15:59 left here in the first half of the Jack Stevens Center. Our score, it's UALR 6, Northwestern State 2.
And now your Arkansas Democrat Gazette UALR Student Athlete of the Game. A senior from Searcy, Arkansas, Rachel Mania, is a four-year letterman on the UALR women's soccer team. She ranks in the top 15 in school history for goals scored, assists, and points, and is in the Sun Belt Conference representative on the NCAA Division I Student Athlete Advisory Committee. Mania has a 3.59 cumulative grade point average and is pursuing a degree in health and exercise science. Rachel Mania is your Arkansas Democrat Gazette UALR Student Athlete of the Game.
Retirement dreams into reality. Your modern Woodman agent can help you sort through your complicated financial
It's
choices.
Now time for the Car Dealer Shootout, sponsored by Landers Toyota. Meet Alan Lockhart, who will be shooting for $200 if he makes a three-point shot. Community.
Call Albert Hurst at 501-374-4077.
So close, but so far away. Thanks, Alan. Brought to you by Landers Toyota.
Modern Woodman of America. Touching lives, securing futures.
Hungry? With over 500 restaurants to choose from, Little Rock has something for every appetite and budget. Best of all, you'll never have to do the dishes again. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, delicious choices and tons of variety all the time. Don't wait for a special occasion to dine out today. To learn more about where you can eat in Little Rock, go to dinelr.com and bring your appetite. This message brought to you by the Little Rock Convention and Visitors Bureau.
UALR leads here in the early going, 6-2 over Northwestern State out of Louisiana. Trojans are 2-6 from the field, 33%. The Demons are 1-4, 25%. And again, their shot blocker Mosley on the bench, having picked up two quick fouls. And so he will sit probably most of the rest of the first half, I would suspect, depending on what goes on during the course of the game. Davis with it off the dribble in front of the UALR bench, working against DeAndre Williams, who's one of the better defenders in the Sun Belt. Left-hand corner, it goes to Ellis. Ellis from long range, no good. Will Neighbor, who just checked in at 6'10", with a rebound. And Neighbor and Chavez, Neighbor replaced Chavez in the lineup. Two totally different players. Will Neighbor can play out on the floor, whereas Chavez can't. And Neighbor won the three-point shooting contest the other night here at the Jack Stevens Center. DeAndre Williams takes it all away, uncontested.
DeAndre Williams!
UALR.
You see how the threat of Neighbor making that three allowed Williams to get that open lane with the big guy.
I'd like to see Williams do more of that penetrating. Outside, it is Davis and Williams. They'll lob it inside. Holman on the right side. He'll pull up and try to shoot it over Will Neighbor. Shot is no good. Hit the rim and then the top of the backboard. Dead ball. It'll belong to the Trojan.
What we see, too, is some of these
checking in the ball game for the Demons.
Jump shots, Northwestern State's taken. They're going to get long rebounds. So you got to
number one, Demetrius Jacobs. Number 10, Patrick Robinson. Number 11, John Briscoe. And number 40, Marvin Frazier.
Tamar Sutherland, DeAndre Williams, Eric Lawton, Will Neighbor, and Courtney Jackson, the five out on the floor for UALR. Only a couple of those guys were in the starting lineups, Williams and Jackson. Lawton, excellent guard, and he'll get it to Jackson, lob down low. Will Neighbor had it and tried to go up with it too quick and lost it out of bounds.
Well executed, though. They gave him a pick and roll and got it right to him in the paint where he should have scored it.
Had the guy on his hip, had an easy two if he can hang on to it. A lot of banging going on inside with Will Neighbor. Left side it comes to Robinson. Top of the circle, Holman with it. Hosell substitutions for Northwestern. We were told they will run five in, and then the next thing you know, here comes another
UALR foul on number two, Tramar Sutherland. First personal foul, fourth team foul.
It does. Just when you're getting the flow of things, here comes five new guys. It is Demons basketball, right side of the basket on the end line. They get a fresh 35. 14-17 to play. They shoot one from the corner. No good. Whistle and a foul. And they'll get Robinson for coming over the back of Tamar Sutherland. It was a long rebound. And he just
Northwestern State foul. Number 10, Patrick Robinson. First personal foul. Third team foul.
That's a great strategy if the refs aren't looking. Sure.
Rebounds. You and I never got a rebound, did we?
No. Those are the big guys for that.
You might have gotten one of those long rebounds and a rare miss that you had on a three. We're near the 14-minute mark. DeAndre Williams penetrates, kicks it in the corner. Sutherland wide open.
Tramar Sutherland!
Sutherland with his first bucket of the afternoon. 10-2, UALR 3-7 from the field. Northwestern ice cold, 1-7. They're looking, first of all, to get it inside. Can't do so. They lob it out front, almost turn it over. Saved by Frazier. And there's Sutherland coming in, and Sutherland slapped it away.
Great ball pressure by UALR right now. That, you know, you pressure the ball, then you push up in those passing lanes. It gets the offense totally out of sync.
Inbounds it comes. Along the baseline, fallaway jumper's up, and it is good.
Demetrius Jacobs.
Can't really play much better defense than that. That was a tough shot.
Demetrius Jacobs with a bucket. 10-4, UALR by 6. That was the first basket by Jacobs. Williams will favor left side of the floor, far side as he crosses the timeline. Looking for a screen, doesn't get it, penetrates, drops it off to Tramar Sutherland, and Sutherland was either fouled or stepped on the end line. I think he stepped out of bounds.
That was one of those possessions. Where I'm
checking in the ball game for the Trojans. Number 21, Marlon Luzero.
Moving the ball really well, and it's been because Will Neighbor, he opens up the offense because that big guy is so afraid of him shooting the jump shot.
Speaking of big guys, Marlon Luzero, 6'7", out of Brazil, checks in for UALR. He's a wide body. Briscoe with it. Out front to Holman. Holman takes it off the dribble against Neighbor, has it slapped away, and they say it was the last touch by a UALR player, so it'll be Demons ball, left side of the hoop. Turnovers, UALR with two, each team with two. And that was a play that did not work. They threw the ball inbounds. The guy was going out of bounds, ended up trying to save it, and he threw it to the guy who had been out of bounds with it, and he tried to jump inbounds, couldn't do that. So UALR will get it on the turnover. DeAndre Williams waves everybody else off. Steve Shields doing a lot of coaching at this juncture of the season. Every coach does it this early, but he's got a lot of young players, spends a lot of time kneeling down, showing them game situations. Here's what you do if you get in a situation like that. And Lawton just took steps.
And that was just, that offense was out of sync. Last couple of possessions, they've been out of sync. But the defense has been able to hold. They've been just creating such problems for the Northwestern guards because of that ball pressure.
Team fouls, UALR with four, Northwestern with three. Two of those on Mosley, their shot blocker supreme. That was kind of a wild play there. The ball had was slapped away. It hit the top. Did it hit the shot clock?
Yeah, hit the shot clock.
Checking in the ball game for UALR, number 24, Ben Billard.
It was not a shot, though. Somebody did slap it away. Changing the lineup for UALR, Ben Dillard, a freshman, has come in. So you got Lawton, Dillard, Neighbor, Lazaro, and Williams. So you got three new faces on the floor for UALR. Lawton takes it off the dribble, left side, kicks it in the corner. It went to Ben Dillard. Dillard dribbled it off of his foot out of bounds.
That kills you as a coach. That's back.
Checking in
back
the ball game for the Trojans. Turnovers. Number 13, Chuck Guy.
It was a mistake by the both ball handlers, and that is just got to drive them nuts.
And when you play a new guys, things like that happen. You get different combinations. Both teams playing a lot of combinations. From out front, it is Holman. Shot is no good. Battle for the rebound. Davis has it inside the paint. And they will get Dillard for the reach-in foul. That'll be the fifth team foul against UALR and the first against Dillard.
And that's your long rebound right there. And they were going for
UALR foul on number 24, Ben Dillard. First personal foul, fifth team foul. That's a line to shoot two for Northwestern State, Marvin Frazier.
But it's about containing that ball handler, right? And they haven't done it last couple times, and it's hurt them.
Frazier, who shoots 50% on the season at the line, misses the first. Trojans are 4 of 8 from the field now, 50%. And Northwestern, 2 of 9. And as Frazier's numbers show, he's a 50% shooter. He made 1 of 2. Neighbor runs the baseline, gets it inbounds to Lawton. Back to Neighbor. Will has it as he crosses midcourt, and they will get the Demons for a reach-in foul, and that's number 4 on them.
That was the first time we've seen Northwestern.
Demons foul on number 1, Demetrius Jacobs. First personal foul, fourth team foul.
That foul was on Jacobs, his second, so he's one of two.
We've got a media timeout.
Who has some foul problems. We got 11:59 left in the half. It's slowed down a little bit here. We'll take a media timeout with UALR leading 10-5.
We all know basketball players get injuries. So do weekend warriors. If you're a runner or play golf, softball, or tennis, your physical exertion is causing stress on your joints. If you're lucky, the occasional ice pack or anti-inflammatory medicine may be all you ever need. But if you need medical treatment or surgery, there's only one place you should go. UAMS Orthopedics. Knees, shoulders, elbows, ankles, hands, take it to the ones who teach you. UAMS. Visit UAMSHealth.com.
So, what's the big news?
I was just offered a new job.
That's great. Is it more money?
It was less about the money and more about the benefits.
Really?
Yeah, they offer great employee benefits from Transamerica Life Insurance Company, along with medical. So I get to choose coverage for my family and myself. Premiums are deducted from my paycheck, and I can take the coverage with me, even if I change jobs.
Cool. Do you get more days off?
Right.
Ask your Transamerica benefit advisor how we can help make a better tomorrow for your next potential top-notch hire. Learn more at TransamericaEmployeeBenefits.com.
It's game time, and we're coming at you live from Boston's, your sports
Mike's
headquarters.
Here come the challengers, and boy, do they look hungry.
More stats.
Let's take a look at their opponents. First
fans, get your pizza and salads from U.S. Pizza, now available in the concession stand.
What a lineup. This game's too close to call. I guess from the Peewees to the pros, everyone's a winner at Boston's.
You said it. Whether it's before, during, or after the game, Boston's is the best place to bond with your team.
Talk sports, eat Boston's.
We have played just over 8 minutes. UALR leading Northwestern Louisiana 10-5. Northwestern State out of Louisiana. I don't think they go by Northwestern Louisiana anymore, so we will make sure we get that correct. Trojans with the basketball. Inbounds, it comes to Lawton. Off the dribble, top of the circle. Looking for the cutter. He goes to Dillard on the left side. Dillard, nice-looking freshman. He'll give it to Lazaro. Right side, it goes to Lawton. Down inside to Will Neighbor. Neighbor with the leaner. That's his shot partially deflected, and Northwestern State comes away with it. I think Will is much better off just shooting a fall-away jumper on that, but those are things you learn. And out of the corner, it is Robinson with the three.
Three-point basket, Patrick Robinson.
State, 10-8 game. Backboard court pressure, full court pressure, I should say. Slapped out of bounds. It'll still belong to UALR.
You saw a lot of the pressure now picking up from Northwestern State. These guys have to be mentally tough and get spacing to break this press.
Inbounds, it comes to Will Neighbor, who will, off the dribble, take it across, try to get across midcourt, comes shy of that. Now he's got to get rid of it. Does so the Lawton. Lawton into the corner. Dillard wide open for the three. Shot is up, and it is no good. Rebound, Holman of Northwestern State. Here come the Demons, and they're picking up the pace a little bit, doing so with their defense. Lawton working out front against Briscoe. Briscoe, fall away, Jay, short of the mark, no good. Mazzaro did a nice job botting his guy out of bounds, not allowing him to get to the basketball, and UALR will get it.
You know, that's, I like that, but I would have liked to see him get that rebound and get it up the floor so you don't get...
Checking in the ball game for Northwestern State, Shamir Davis, as well as Gary Robertson, O.J. Evans, and Luis Ellis.
Good point. Inbounds, it comes to Lawton. He will be pressured, but everybody else drops back. Eric Lawton, 6 foot junior out of California. Played 2 years ago with DeAndre Williams, same junior college. Trojans with 18 on the shot clock. DeAndre Williams will make that Dillard with it off the dribble. He will get it to Will Neighbor. Neighbor for two from long range. Got it. Will Neighbor was standing
Will Neighbor!
I knew where his feet were, but just knocked it down anyway. His first basket of the afternoon, 12-8 UALR. Out of the corner, it is Ellis from long range. No good. Dillard battling for the rebound. There was contact between he and a Northwestern State player.
Checking the ball game for UALR, number 44, Michael Chavez.
Northwestern State will have it.
And number 12, Courtney Jackson.
The reason why you want to contain the
Also checking in for the Trojans, number 10, DeAndre Williams.
They penetrated and then kicked for a jump shot. So if you got to, you got to keep your man in front of you so you don't need help.
Chavez is checked back into the game for Will Neighbor. Overplayed his guy, slapped it out of bounds. It was the Demons ball in the far corner, and they find the jump shooter inbounds.
Three-point basket, Shamir Davis.
And it's a one-point game. 12-11, UALR leads it. Both coaching staffs up, working awful hard. DeAndre Williams brings it across. UALR offensively has got to get in sync. Chuck Guy right in front of the Demon bench. Can't get anything off. Kicks it back out front to DeAndre Williams. 16 on the shot clock. DeAndre backs it all the way out to midcourt now. Directs traffic. Chavez working down low against Evans. DeAndre Williams now pulls up. Long-range jumper. No good. Long rebound. Dillard takes it all the way to the rack. Lays it up and in.
Ben Dillard!
Shot by Williams on that offensive rebound.
14-11 UALR. In the paint, running jumpers up. It is good. That is Ellis. That
Luis
was way
Ellis.
Too easy offensively for Northwestern State. They have yet to lead in the game. 14-13. UALR would like to score again. Chavez tried a little fancy pass to Courtney Jackson, who was only about 3 feet away. Pass was too hard. Couldn't handle it. Demons with the basketball. They'll lob it inside. It goes to Stewart. Stewart backing his way down against Chavez. Shot's no good. Steve Shields wanted to travel. Didn't get it. Pass it. The rebound's tipped out to Chuck Guy. Guy loses the handle. Back the other way. Here comes Davis of Northwestern State. Lets it fly from long range. Missed everything. And trying to save it was Robertson, but he stepped on the end line.
Right now, Northwestern State's got it the way they want it to go. Quick, they love to come up and shoot the three quick. They've been able to do that a couple of times. It's paid off for them. UALR has got to take care of the ball, right? Then again, back-to-back turnovers.
UALR's turned it over 6 times. Northwestern State just 4. But the pace right now, as Pat pointed out, favors the Demons. DeAndre Williams slows it down, working out front. Steve Shields has seen enough. He didn't. His guys.
Timeout on the floor. UALR.
Timeout.
Yeah, that's a great timeout because it's almost like guys on where they're supposed to be offensively. Michael Chavez has the ball.
Lose control. A body and soul. Don't move too fast. People just take it slow. Don't get ahead. Just jump into it. Y'all hear about it? The P's will do it. Get started. Get stupid. Everybody, people will walk you through it step by step like an infant new kid. Inch by inch with a new solution. Transmit hits with no delusion. The feeling's irresistible and that's how we move it.
Yo, everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoked, get started, get started.
How about a win this afternoon? That would go a long way, making everybody feel a little bit better here. Trojans 0-1 on the year. Northwestern State 1-0. Chavez, right side, squares up. Now Michael puts it on the floor. Turnaround jumper is good.
Wow.
It counts.
How about that move from the big fella? He says, no, I don't need to be in the paint. I'm just going to hit me a turnaround fadeaway.
Northwestern State foul, number 35, O.J. Evans.
Nice
at the line, shooting one, Michael Chavez.
Have a nice touch. He's got a really nice jump hook down in that paint, unlike any UALR players had in a while, I will tell you that. He's 21 years old, a freshman out of Columbia. Shot is up, it is no good. Gillard kept it alive, but couldn't hang on to it. Here comes Davis pushing it down the floor for the Demons. Still off the dribble, he takes it, dishes it off. They take it to the rack. There's Chavez with a block. There's another block by Chavez, and they say Chuck Guy reached in and got him. I don't think that Chavez will get credit for two blocks, just the one, but.
UALR foul number 13, Gary Chuck Guy. Robertson first personal foul, sixth team foul at the line to shoot two.
That's a sixth team
Gary
foul.
Robertson.
UALR one more, and Northwestern State will be in the 1-1.
Seems really the difference as he misses that shot that we've seen this second half, second part of the first half has been Northwestern has been able to get in the belly of the defense, and you create so many issues with dribble penetration, and you see it right here with fouls and open jump shots.
Northwestern State hits one of two. 16-14, your Trojans by two. We'll be back here Tuesday night against IUPUI. Chuck Guy floater along the baseline. That's one of his favorite shots. Can't get it to go, though. And Northwestern State will push it down the floor very quickly. Ellis pulls up from long range right in front of the UALR bench, and Northwestern State
3-point basket, Luis Ellis.
17-16 as we go under the 8-minute mark. You knew they would heat up sooner or later. They're 5 of 17, 2 of 8 on threes. Andre Williams doing a lot of dribbling with it. Into the corner to Chuck Guy. Almost at a point where one guy could guard both of them.
We've got a media timeout.
We got a media timeout. 7:42 left in the half. Our score, Northwestern State out of Louisiana, leading UALR.
All right, everyone, let's hear you cheer for the Arkansas Federal Credit Union T-shirt toss. If you want a T-shirt, you got to make some noise.
Capital Business Machines, 375-1111.
For over 84 years, the Daily Record has been Central Arkansas' source for all your current courthouse and real estate news. From mortgages and realtors' hot sheets to tax liens and corporate filings, the Daily Record keeps you informed with current business information.
That T-shirt broke toss brought to you by Arkansas Federal Credit Union.
374-5103 to subscribe. Visit us online at www.dailyrecord.us.
30 seconds, guys.
If you have a busy schedule and are in need of one place to shop rather than running all over town, try Lakewood Village in North Little Rock. It's one-stop shopping from head to toe. We offer the finest clothing and shoe stores to meet your needs. If you want to catch a movie or go to lunch or dinner, you can do
never
that.
Never had a game where I really look forward to the timeouts.
Also available for doctors, dentists, and MRI specialists. If it's some leisure time you're looking for, then take a walk around the pavilion and lake for some exercise. That's Lakewood Village, your home away from home.
I'm being real disappointed in you, you know that. Back at the Jack Stevens Center on this beautiful Sunday afternoon, Ray Tucker along with the shooter, Pat Bradley. As you